So how big of a difference could a female president make? Carolyn Maloney is U.S. House Democrat representing the state of New York, and she joins me now. Thank you so much for being with us,
well,
Representative.
Thank you for focusing on empowering women.
It is. And it's an issue.
Voice.
It is an issue that we talk about a lot on this show. I want to ask you, the U.S. is often seen as a champion of women's rights, and yet we've never had a female leader. What kind of message would that send to the world if we do in November?
Well, I would argue that we've had many female leaders. We haven't had a female president, but certainly our first ladies, even this conference was filled with,
yes,
with female leaders. But I think it's incredibly important. Hillary Clinton had a huge impact in 1995 when she went to the World Conference on Women and said that women's rights are human rights, human rights are women's rights. I was part of that delegation representing Congress, and in that meeting and many others, she has elevated the debate and discussion on women's issues to a national and international level. Usually they were sort of not thought about or thought about the secondly or thirdly or not thought about at all. But now with her candidacy and really with more women leaders in Congress and a woman speaker and women cabinet members, women's issues are more in the forefront. And when women are in powerful issues, you see a tremendous difference in public policy and working conditions and laws and efforts to really strengthen the family. And the old saying is, when you educate a woman, you educate her family, you educate her village, you educate her nation.
And we heard a lot of that yesterday, and there is a feeling that we are at a tipping point. Things have changed, and this is no longer a social issue. This has become a core rights issue, a core economic issue. If you lift women, you're going to be able to lift GDP. How important is the issue of gender pay? I know it's something that you've done a lot of work on, and what more can the government do on that front?
I would say the most important thing we could do, and we are the greatest country on earth, and we are nicer to our women, all of our people. A democracy protects our rights in many ways. But we are not in the Constitution. If you want to close and that wage gap, then you have to put women in the Constitution and guarantee their rights by law. There has been court cases where in a undisputed rate, the Brancala case, she sued and went to the federal courts, to the Supreme Court, and they ruled she did not have standing because women were not in the Constitution. So let's put women in the Constitution and give them the right to fight discrimination with the laws. Mm-hmm. It's a documented fact that there is tremendous discrimination. For 30 years, we've been 79 cents to the dollar.
Yeah.
When I started working, we were 50 cents to the dollar. We've gotten a pay raise, but it's still unfair. And for African-American women, it's 60 cents to the dollar. For Latino women, 55 cents to the dollar. Totally unfair.
Which is incredible.
And the single mothers, and when you discriminate against a woman, You discriminate against the entire family and,
yes,
and the rights of that family.
And we've seen when you support women, the halo effect through the community is amazing. That fantastic statistics on that. Private sector, we heard Michelle Obama and Oprah Winfrey make a pointed address to employers, to business leaders, that if you are not operating in a diverse workplace, do better. How important is their involvement and buy-in for this? And are you seeing change when you talk to people?
I am seeing change in corporations and particularly consultants because they see the difference. We just did a report on women on boards that were done by financial think tanks. And they said when there are more women on boards, the GDP, the output of the board is better because another perspective is brought in, yet women are only 12% of boards. We have women leaders in business, but still the number is very, very small. And the women change, but the number remains small. In some areas, the private sector is leading government. I'd say paid leave for the birth of a child. We are among two countries in the world that do not provide paid leave for the birth of a child. Some companies, the private sector, are ahead of government in that respect. We are tied with Papua New Guinea. So
which we have talked about on this show, I can assure you. So I think the encouraging message is that while we've come a long way, much needs to be done, but there are a lot of amazing men and women who are pushing harder on that, including yourself. Thank you so much for the work you're doing on that. Please come back and join us again.
Including your work, and thank you for adding a voice to women working in America.
And we'll continue to do that. Thank you so much.
Thank you.